often?
No, only once.
Cracked.
About 100,000.
it on the table.
Between the hammer and the knife that's stabbing at my fingers, I'm lucky to have any fingers left.
Oh, I'm sorry you had to spill your blood for the fruitcake. I hope you'll think it's worth it. Hand me the molasses.
When's it gonna be ready?
In time for Christmas.
2 weeks? What's it gonna bake so long?
It doesn't bake 2 weeks, only 3 hours. Now that's spoon. Thanks. But then we store it in the cellar till Christmas in the branded cloth. Hand me that bowl of cherries. As usual, we're a little low on nuts and short on fruit, but I guess it'll turn out all right. You want to help stir?
I'm here.
Oh, sorry. So you were telling me before about nativity practice. You were shepherd again?
This year I wanted the king, the one that brings the mirror.
What mirror?
Well, that's what Pastor Bob said. Joey's the king that brings the gold. Rolf brings the frankincense, and I bring the mirror.
That mirror? Who else is in the play?
Harriet Spillman's the head angel. Billy's Joseph. Edith Wetzel's the Virgin Mary. She and Harriet get in a big argument over who had the most important part. Edith said she did because it's harder to be a virgin than it is to be an angel.
From the mouths of babes.
And then, Pastor Bob said the shepherd fellow looks sore afraid.
Oh, how do you look sore afraid?
Like this. Which would be nuts you wanted.
I see. Walnuts?
And Billy bought his brother's tablet.
His what?
It's this round that you blow it up and squeeze it and makes a sound just like
I know the sound.
Well, blew it up and went into the hay next to the manger, and Harriet, she floated in a way to like it. I sat down right where she said, and so it came to pass.
I'm not surprised. What surprises me is you boys not behaving yourselves.
I didn't do it, Billy did.
But you knew he put that cow ladder there. You could have warned Harriet.
Ma.
I'm not scolding. I'm just saying I would have thought you boys would be on your best behavior this close to Christmas. Chris Kindle could be watching. You know he doesn't bring presents to troublemakers.
Billy thinks we don't have to worry about that.
Oh, really?
He says that Chris Kindle spends his time with the city boys because they live closer together and he can watch more at one time. He says we're too spread out here, so he doesn't bother watching us.
I wouldn't be so sure about that. Seems to me, if Chris Kindle can manage to buy you a present, he can manage to look in on you now and again.
Dear,
what a shame, what a shame. you can polish all the silver, you can open up the cans, you can fight off the table, you can slice up the bread.
Slice up the bread.
You're done with this, boy. That's what love is on.
That's what love is on. That's what love is on. Love is on. How?
The 11th? He thought they might be back by the 15th. Of course, it all depends.
On what?
Well, the weather. The winds. Excuse me.
Where do you think he'll get me?
I don't know.
Can I open it right away?
Of course not. We gotta wait till Christmas.
December's the longest month in the whole year.
It is this year. Meanwhile, there's plenty to do around here. I've got baking, you've got chores. Did you give Diamond Lady her feedback?
Yeah, she was hungry too.
And finish bringing in all the wood like I asked?
Some.
We'll go finish. It'll be dark soon. Thank the good Lord, there's always so much to do.
Thanks.
Just measure the reason. Measure the warts and weasels. Mix in the flour and butter and sip in nutmeg too. Oh, Carl! Carl, you forgot your...
Hello, Mrs. Stossel.
Peter.
Came back early. Disappointed?
Oh, good Lord, no!
You know, he has one just like you in every port.
Where's Carl?
Oh, I just sent him to finish his chores, but how did you get...
I want Carl to hear this, too. Carl? Carl!
Mom, is that you?
Come on in, son.
That walk up the hill never gets any shorter.
Pa!
There's our boy. Did you take care of your mama?
You bet. Over!
Carl, missed you.
You are not going to believe what happened. We pulled into the Clark Street dock and there were, 500, maybe 600 people there waiting for us.
Waiting?
They even had a sign. Welcome, Christmas Schooner.
Oh.
Can you believe it?
Martha had gone around her neighborhood telling everyone a schooner carrying Christmas trees was coming in, and they had all been waiting there at the dock since morning. I thought it would take a week to sell all the trees.
If we could sell it all.
But by evening that first day, there wasn't a tree left. We sold every one of them!
That's great! Did you get me anything?
So I gave the crew the next day off to see some sights, do some shopping, and then we hoisted anchor and came home.
Oh, that's wonderful.
So I've been hopping around the house.
I wish you could have seen their faces on them. Older couples, children.
Tell me, Tywood.
Well, a girl came up to me and showed me paper ornaments she made for the tree. She'd never even seen a Christmas tree, but her folks told her.
We didn't stop?
They were all talking about where they're going to put the tree and how they're going to decorate it. It was like a big party right there on the dock. They were singing, Joy to the World.
And we were singing,
Make way for Molly. Grandfather clock you've been wanting.
Seth Thomas.
Where do you want it?
In the front room for now, I guess.
We'll uncrate it later.
You heard her. Into the front room.
Thanks, Oscar.
We can do it without you.
A hot slide here.
Good thing it all worked well.
Coffee. I might have a little strudel left.
So tell me, Carl, what have you been up to?
Lots of things. Shoveling, baking bread, sweeping, feeding the stock, chopping firewood.
Peter, you shouldn't have.
Surprised?
But it must have cost so
much. Never mind. You deserve it.
I think I better stoke the fire.
You're doing fine.
I meant the stove.
Down the strudel, Mrs. Dawson.
Don't be silly, everybody's waiting.
I know, let them be.
Would you hand me the tray?
Put down I the strudel, the tray. Mrs. Dawson.
I can't, I need you
I
to.
I need you to come dance
let
with me.
Let me see that sugar bring in another chair.
Your apron and put it away. Bring your pretty self. Find something to your liking in the box on top. Why don't you go into the parlor and open it?
You mean I can open it now?
Sure, now. Come on, Steve.
Oma.
I'll bring in your coffee when it's ready.
It's heavy.
Go on, open it.
Is this something I asked for?
I think so.
Skates? Potty skates?
Single blades. They fit right over your shoes, too.
Look at them.
They're great.
Well, I was going to wait for Christmas, but I...
No, I'm coming here to see another skate.
Mrs. Stossel!
Christmas came a little early this year. I'm glad you like them.
Mom!
German.
Oh.
Just can't tell him much.
Fresh water suits me fine. I'm a hard water sailor, and that's the life for me. Oh, listen to her howl. We'll make port tonight. We're the mighty men who sail through the squalls and the gales that call us. Fresh water, sweet waters too. Oh, I'd rather by far be a hard water tar than to sail upon the ocean blue. And it's a hard water sailor I'm proud to be. We sail upon the inland sea. We don't yearn for ports afar, or happy where we are, being hard water sailors upon the inland sea.
Yeah.
load of trees from the stern cabin pool.
Cutters did their job this year, Captain. Loaded her as best we could. We ain't got much freeboard left.
I don't want it too heavy. Maybe we should unload some of this.
It's well last. She can carry the load.
Well, maybe for once we'll have enough trees, eh? Weigh anchor.
Weigh anchor.
Anchor's away.
Make sail. Haul away.
November 30th. The wind suddenly shifted south-southeast, and we sailed straight to the teeth of a winter storm. This fell apart. Wind shifted again, gusting to 70, then 75 miles. By nightfall, blinding snow.
Captain! She's in the harbor of port!
I'm fighting her every inch! The way the sea is washing over those trees will be nothing but ice!
She's always made it through before! And I'm not sure the schooner's gonna make it through this!
She has to make it! She's the only schooner we got!
Ah!
It blows up!
The engines have broken off! What is going on?
Damn! Man, the pumps!
All those plastic snap trees are going to blow before!
We gotta get to shelter!
Awesome. Well, I speak for the crew. Captain Stossel was the finest man we ever shipped out on there.
We're just glad you and the others are all right, Steve.
Well, we're all pretty beat up. If it hadn't been for your husband, ma'am, we wouldn't be here at all. I mean, how he kept his bearings in the middle of that snowstorm? I mean, you can see a blasted thing for hours. And then he kept the model into the wind, and while the rest of us got in the lifeboat and... just sorry, but like I said, you never sail when you're a finer man.
Thanks, Steve.
Remember when George Hoffman was drowned?
Sure, 3 summers back. He went overboard off Wiggins Reef. We searched, but he never came up.
I took a casserole to his wife the next week. Left with those 3 girls. She kept looking at me the whole time I was there. She never said a word, she just looked. But the whole time I knew what she was thinking. Why is your husband alive and mine drowned? I haven't been able to look her in the eye since. Maybe now I can.
Well, I'll leave you folks be.
Wait, Steve. We should tell her.
Why don't you wait, Ben?
We don't have time to wait. We've got to get there.
Where? Tell me what.
Captain Thompson, the skipper of the rescue
boat. What about
him? He came to the hospital last night to see us. The trees, you see, they broke their lashings in the storm.
Mrs. Stossel, when the molly broke and went under, everything in the cargo hold was set loose. Some 2-3 days later, them trees, they started washing up on the shore. From one end of the bay to the other, hundreds of them. Captain Thompson, well, he came to talk to Carl, Carl being the son-in-law, asked him what he wanted done with them.
Done? Get rid of them. I never want to see another Christmas tree again.
We got talking to the captain. He's got a schooner. It's laid in for winter right now, but it wouldn't take more than a day or two to get it ready.
Ready for what?
He's got a crew that would help us load the trees onto the schooner. Sure, it would take us 3 or 4 days to get them all loaded up and get ready, but today's Tuesday, and Steve thinks we could weigh anchor by Saturday.
Wait. Anchor? You're telling me after what you just went through, you'd actually get out on that lake again?
We took a vote, Mrs. Stossel, to a man. It's what we thought Captain Stossel would want us to do.
You and the others can do what you like. It's your lives. But Carl's not going anywhere but home. By train, every inch of the way, if I could.
No. Mom, we voted. We decided. We're going to get those trees to Chicago before Christmas.
You listen good. You decide nothing! I lost my husband because of those trees. I'm not going to lose you too!
Storms broke. Once you find your sail, it'll only be a couple days to Chicago.
No.
Popo, you haven't said a word. What do you think?
I think you two need to go back to your room. Let me and your ma talk about this. Just go on.
Don't ask me to say yes. I can't.
I'm not going to tell you what to do.
All week long, I've watched you, waiting for you to cry out.
filled his sails, and made his living, could become a sudden angry force to turn up. He knew that the same calm water that lapped against his bow could rise up 50 feet and come crashing down. And yes, he is grave. Those are the laws he lived with, and he accepted them. And that same man was your husband and my son. He'd come into our lives and make each day we shared with him a day to treasure. That same man can be taken from us. It is the law we live with, and we must accept it. Would you rather Peter had never lived, never touched our lives at all? Then, if we accept our blessings, we must accept our pain. Do I weep that my son has died? I weep. Did I weep when my wife, my Greta, died? I wept. But if we grieve, it is because we have loved and been loved. I loved my son. And that's why I think Carl and the others need to get those trees to Chicago. And I know one gray-haired, broken-armed son of a sea cook who's going with them.
He'll never understand.
I was there when he once asked Peter, "Why are you going? Do you remember what he told you? Because if I don't do it, it won't get done." That's what we're feeling now. I remember back in Bremen. I remember Peter's face, the way he looked at me. People thought that I was crazy, risking everything to cross the sea. I remember when I asked him, go and take a chance, should we stay? Even now I see his eyes, and they help me find my way. Something happened in Chicago when we landed with the first load of trees that day. Something happened to the people. All their anger, all their shouting seemed to fade away. People started saying, "Merry Christmas," shaking hands and singing carols in the snow. I remember Christmas just like it was back in Bremen long ago. Tomorrow I'll get you a ticket back to Manistee.
You won't. I'm coming with you.
No, this is safe. The schooner's not a place
to go. Just, if I go, where no one goes.
Are you sure?
Yes,
won't be good.
Excuse me, daughters. Excuse me, ma'am, but I watched you dock that schooner. That's the Christmas schooner, ain't it?
No. Yes, we brought the trees, you see.
I knew it! I've come down here every night this week waiting for you. We tossed it out of staff, wasting me time. So the schooner was not come north, so there weren't going to be no ship this year. But I knew you were wrong. I knew you'd come.
What's your name?
Mary Kelly Doherty.
I'm almost also.
Pleasure, ma'am.
You're Irish. And what's an Irish girl doing wanting the Tannenbaum?
And why not?
Well, I thought it was just a journey.
You should have seen the tree we got last year. It was almost as big as Mr. Sabatini's.
Sabatini?
They live on the first floor under us. They got the biggest tree on the whole schooner last year. That's why I'm going to be first in line this time and get first choice.
If your Da told you that the schooner had gone under, what made you think the trees would be here?
They had to. What's Christmas without a Christmas tree?
You tell your dog he is wrong. The Molly Doom went down, it's true, but there are other ships and other men and lots more trees up north. You tell him that the Christmas schooner sailed into the Clark Street dock this year, and it will every year.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, wait! Here. You take this. Our blessings aren't ours to keep, Mary Claire. They're meant to be passed along.
May this branch bring you long.
May this branch bring you love.
Take it and pass it on.
May this branch bring you love.
Take it and pass it on.
Life and sail the lake so that others may know the joy of Christmas.